Hi, Jathan. Thanks for being here with us.
Hi, Mikey. It's wonderful to be here.
Okay, Jathan, tell us about the COVID response education program that you just launched on March 28th in response to this pandemic.
So we created this program called Escuela Pamilya, which is a free Facebook after-school program wherein we deliver 300 lessons to public school students and their families. Since March 28th, we delivered these lessons and been having these classes. We currently have 11 students on the platform, all from 80 cities all over the Philippines.
And this wasn't an existing trajectory. You jumped off, being the founder and executive director of the AHA Learning Center. You've got 11 years of experience since 2009 in the field of education. Now, in response to this pandemic, you had to transition. So now, with the use of a smartphone and cellular connectivity, you provide classes to children, the classroom experience via Facebook Messenger. Can you tell us how you were able to do this, Jathan?
So when we were as a community center and on the eve of actually a couple of days after the lockdown hit, my phone was blowing up with all of these cries for help and cries of basically anxiety, fears, and we just tried to figure out a way to be there for the community that we've been serving. So when we figured out that everybody was on Facebook Messenger, and then we realized that, you know what, words do matter, and words can actually give lessons, because we were always in this thinking that, you know, text isn't enough. We were able to see Facebook Messenger, a free text-based platform for all Filipinos using free basics. As a way to not only give comfort, but also to have these families use their time productively.
Okay, in this new normal, you bring the classroom to the students via Facebook Messenger. Can you tell us about what this new classroom experience is like? What is the student-teacher ratio? How often are classes conducted? And how the response has been?
So, this classroom, so I guess just to get everybody, if you look at your phone right now and you probably are messaging one or two people, imagine there are 50 more people there. And instead of your messenger group with your friends, imagine that it was a classroom and that there was just one person there that would play teacher. In that classroom, instead of sending sweet nothings or whatever, even jokes, you would send lessons that were filled with emojis that you would use not only to give reactions, but the emojis actually would take place of pictures. This simple way and simple understanding of how most of us are already on Messenger already, talking and chatting, made us realize that why not learning? And in each classroom, there are 50 to 250 people. And we found that the kids not only thrived in that system, but that's actually their new language. That's already been their language for a while. So it was us catching up, that this is how learning could be, since they were already there chatting and talking the whole day.
Mm-hmm. Well, Jathan, this is the most quiet classroom ever, though you're empowering these kids with a different kind of voice. Tell us about this learning exercise. How long can you conduct a class on Facebook Messenger? And can any of those hundreds of students just send a message asking a question? You guys would be inundated with queries. How does that work?
So I think it was important to try to create the same systems that you would have in a classroom in the Facebook Messenger. It was important also that the lessons were very relevant. So we discussed or tried to kind of translate all of these very difficult topics that COVID was facing and all of these mental health exercises that might have been for adults and translating it into more kid-friendly terms. So in the same way that in a classroom you would have attendance, we would have attendance, wherein kids would make emojis and put their hands up that they're here. We would have students recite, wherein the teacher would, students would not only recite, but react by liking the message of the teacher. In the message, there are little reactions that you could do. And we found that actually after a while, it was quite clunky and difficult to adjust at first. But we found that students that were shy or students who had not spoken a word in the classroom were speaking out because this was a safe space for them to express themselves. So it was interesting because it was an evolving platform that did only better, that was only better as more users interacted with it.
What's the age range that works best in this kind of Facebook classroom experience?
So AHA Learning Center was, we only focused 6 to 16 years old. But then strangely enough, when we started promoting this and started putting it out free to download on our website, ahalearningcenter.com, we've gotten all kinds of people. Mikey, we've gotten like recovering drug addicts. We've gotten like senior high school students using our material. And incidentally, I guess the lesson or the core of our lesson, which is for self-care and information, spreading the right information, was universal to most ages, almost all ages, I would say.
Okay, Jathan, can you give us an idea of the breadth and scope of this this educational platform that you just started during this pandemic? How many students, how many teachers? Go ahead.
So we only have 11,000, we call it families. So every time somebody goes in, we not only take the student, but also the mother. So it's a family. So you have 11,000 families using the platform. And I would like to say we have around 50 to 100 teachers managing everything. So I know that number seems to be very overwhelming, but I guess we have to remember that not everybody's on the same time. And in different cities, there are different ways that they're using and making use of this platform. Like for us here in Manila, we have Escuela Pamilya every day, from Mondays to Friday. In Masbate, they have Escuela Pamilya twice a week. So depending on what the context is, they figure it out.
It seems like such a gargantuan effort and so many limitations and so many people that need this. It's a great social initiative that you've mounted. How big is the need, and are you able to fill, are you able to accept everyone that wants to be a part of it, by either whether they be students or teachers?
So our limitations isn't that there are people that, isn't that if there are people that want it. A lot of people, it seems that we answer a basic need. Basic, if you don't have internet and you have a kid at home, and I have a kid at home, and I think Mikey does also, it's very difficult to have that person engaged, to have the kid engaged. So parang it's kind of a rescue. We're answering a rescue call from these parents. How do you get your children engaged now that they can't go out? How can you explain these difficult concepts to them? The big limiting factor has been really the teachers. We are limited by the number of teachers we have, which is why I'd like to, if I jump the gun.
On that note, go ahead and appeal.
Yes. So I believe that, so what AHA Learning Center, what we say all the time is tayong pagbabago na ating hihintay, or we are the change we've been waiting for. And I believe that right now, with most of us able at home, and if you have the privilege to say yes to help or not, maybe it's time to stop helping with our wallet, but start helping with our time. And by investing your time, by joining our cause, you won't only get to meet these wonderful children from all over the Philippines, but you'd be working hand in hand with these amazing public school teachers who are actually the unsung heroes of this lockdown. If you come in through our website, www.ahalearningcenter.com/volunteer, we would make you go through the process and try to figure out what space would be best for you. We have volunteers that all they do is figure out our coding programs. We have volunteers that all they do is make songs. We have volunteers that all they do is teach and manage kids, and volunteers that want to do with our parents program. So depending on what you're good at and how you want to serve, that's where we'll put you in. That's the place we'll put you in.
Okay, great. Because there are a lot of people that want to help, not necessarily in the capacity as teachers. They can be, regular individuals that just want to help grow the organization or help make it more efficient and effective for the students. Now, if for those that wanted to become a teacher, what are the qualifications?
Naho, that's a very good question. Thank you for asking. But I think right now, because it's on Messenger, a lot of the difficulties of teaching are out. So with Messenger, I noticed that the most important thing is presence. because with the number at Elf, you're inundated with so many different messages coming in and out. How present are you at that moment to see and check whether or not this kid needs help, whether or not this message that the kid says has an underlying theme or something that you need to prod on? Offer now, because a lot of the lessons, since they're text-based, are already done, and most of the teachers just copy-paste these messages in chunks. What we need are attentive and caring people, compassionate people, that will look after our students.
So what's the qualification you're looking at there?
The qualification, I think, is the capacity for compassion. I'm sorry if it's not actual, because I have 16-year-old teachers, I have 74-year-old teachers. We tried to make a classification, and then we found that the best teachers don't fit it. So currently, we believe the secret sauce is the presence, the time, the willingness to help, and some compassion.
Okay, all right. Now, what's the time commitment? What does the time commitment look like?
So you can volunteer from anything from 2 hours a day. Those are the different packs that we do it, and we're open usually 5 to 6 days a week. So from Monday to Saturday.
Okay, very interesting. So can you tell me, what do you think is the current, how would you define the current state of education in the country? And how does Eskwelang Pamilya come in to help bridge the gaps that currently exist?
Well, Mikey, I don't think that all of us understand what the current state of the country is. So I feel like I'm not going to pretend to understand what the solution is or how the landscape is, as every day it changes. But I do believe that our program answers a very basic need, which is how can students without internet access reply to the teachers? How can they send in their quizzes? How can they ask the teacher for help? How can the teacher know if that person is in need or not? Facebook Free allows us to give children access to the teacher and into the classroom. So right now, with that, we're in the middle of training 40,000 teachers that will streamline this method, the Facebook Messenger, into their own classroom to support the learning.
Okay, and Jaden, what inspired you to get into this kind of work?
So what inspired me to get into this work? When I was 19 years old, I was volunteering in a public cemetery for the first 6 years and teaching students there. And I always was just wondering whether or not, I was always wondering why the students, or they became my friends over the years, why they didn't have the same opportunities. And I felt like the last 11 years, my question has always been, how do we get these children into rooms where they can shine? And I feel like education, the more education you get, the better rooms you can be in. So I found that if without education, a lot of these doors are shut. So here with Eskwela Pamilya, what I'm very happy about is not only are we getting the best or the most hopeful children that's within my arm's reach, but now with Facebook Messenger, I'm meeting children from Mindanao, I'm meeting children from Cebu, people I've never met, that only validates what I know to be true, that the Filipino is actually very much excellent.
Right, but the people who need it the most, the students that need it the most. How do you put a smartphone in their hands and provide them with a cellular connectivity to make this class work?
So the interesting thing is that kids want their TikTok, kids want their Messenger. So I've been surprised about the poor communities that have phones, smartphones. So I feel like while 30% of the country really don't have access to these things, the bulk of the majority of Filipinos do have smartphones. And it's not about finding the device into their hands, but trying to figure out if they'll use it properly or understand the potential of the device. That seems to be the challenge.
Okay, so for those that are in this program, how willing are they? How conducive is it to learning? How participative are they? And how beneficial is it to them from an education standpoint?
So with the games, with the critical thinking classes that we have, with the COVID classes, with the wellness classes, there are some skill sets there in terms of that you pick up by doing the activities. But more than the educational skill sets, I find the most important thing that has come out of this was the family bonding. You just basically suddenly have two groups of people that haven't spent that much time with each other, because one's in school, one's in work, and are in this impossibly traumatic experience. And just having a thing that both of you can do together has, I believe, increased a lot of mental health. I have a lot of students that have COVID or have experienced somebody with COVID, and just being able to keep busy and just to be positive has not only, I wouldn't say saved their life, but has greatly improved the quality of living.
Okay. How much hand-holding, how much parental guidance is needed? How much support do the students need from the parents in order to make this an effective and viable learning platform?
So actually, that's the second step that we're always working on. AHA's always worked with parents. So for anyone that has a child and that is doing homeschool now, you know that your child will do creative ways to get out of it. So that's universal, whether you're rich or poor, that happens everywhere. So we found that creating a homeschool environment, which are skill sets that are being taught to private school parents, are things I also teach to public school parents. Even if you live in a room, just having a corner in the room that this is the quiet space where my kid can study, that has proven to have dramatic, I guess, help in terms of making the learning experience for the child more conducive, or the learning environment rather.
Okay, and lastly, Jaden, giving you the floor to appeal to whatever assistance you need currently to make this very inspiring social program work even more.
So I believe that, well, thank you again for being part of this program. This is one of the more thoughtful interviews we've had. So I thank you for this space. I think that right now, with everything that's happening, there's a lot of noise. We're worried about ourselves and we're worried about what will happen in the future. But we have to also have a sense of perspective that our worries really do pale in the worries of the majority of the Filipinos who are going hungry, who will not have access to education, who, if they don't have access to education now, will most likely stop their schooling for the rest of their lives. There's a crisis over a crisis that we will only see the real impact later on with all these problems coming through. So if you have a choice, if it's a question of whether or not you can or cannot, please always say yes to service. Please always say yes to public school education, since we do not have enough good people doing volunteer work, even if we have so many good people in the Philippines.
All right. Well, thank you for that, Jaden. And how do they get in touch with you? If they want to assist, if they want to be a part of this program, how best to reach you?
So you can go through our website, www.ahalearningcenter.com, or you can email me at jaden@ahalearningcenter.com.
All right. Thank you for your time, Jaden Zulueta, the founder and executive director of the AHA Learning Center.